Hello, I'm Olivier from LiveObjects, and I want to present you a new feature called External Connector Mode. To follow this session, I assume that you are familiar with Orange LiveObjects. If you are not, please refer to our beginner's video on this channel. Let's start with the core principles for this connector mode. LiveObject is a software as a service available from the internet. IoT devices connect to it. Traditional IP devices connect with MQTT-S protocol. They send their status and their data payloads. They exchange parameters, status and updates, as well as remote commands and firmwares. LoRaWAN and SMS devices use Orange networks to connect to live objects. They send their payloads and receive downlink commands. Would you have specific devices or personal area network equipment connected to an existing backend? LiveObject offers a connectivity option for all your data to be collected in a single place with many advanced features. A simple piece of software can connect your backend to the LiveObject External Connector API using MQTT-S protocol. For each and every device, it can declare a status, online, offline, publish the data, and receive remote commands. Let's see the details of this feature before demonstrating it. Your devices are connected to your backend or gateway that gathers information. You can easily develop and host the external connector that connects to LiveObject's MQTT-S interface with connector username. Then, the connector publishes status and data frames and subscribes to a command topic. Further device management features will be added, like remote configuration or firmware over the air. Advantages of these solutions are open to proprietary protocols, open to objects which are not able to modify their firmware, and your responsibility is to develop, host, and run the external connector outside of LiveObject, and warranty your SLA besides LiveObject. To demonstrate this functionality, I will use an MQTT client called MQTT Spy, based on Eclipse PoW. You can find the portable version used in the GitHub written in the video description. Now, let's start. I create an API key to access LiveObject from the MQTT connector in the configuration, or soon to be called administration, menu. I simply enter a name, then the profile, and validate. I copy the value. As you can see, no device is existing now on my account. Let's switch to the MQTT client acting as the connector. When launching for the first time, no configuration exists. I am creating one this way. Then I can create a custom connection. Let's call it LiveObject Connector. Enter a random client ID, the URL liveobjects.orange-business.com. On the security tab, I set the username connector, and for the password, I paste the API key that I have just generated. For enhanced security, I activate TLS with CA certificates. TLS 1.2 will be fine, and the certificate that I have downloaded from the Certification Authority's website. The link is in the video description. Apply and open the MQTTS link. Great! We get a green light. Further configurations can be made. You can see them in the guide on GitHub. Let's declare our first device status as online. I will publish a message on the topic connector slash v1 slash nodes slash, let's call it my device 1 slash status. The message body is just a JSON with status online. And publish. So, on Live Object, I can check that the device exists now and is active. Now, if I want to set it offline, easy. I just change the body and publish. On Live Objects, I refresh and see the offline state. Right, now let's send a data message. The topic will be the same apart from status that I replace with data. The simplest body is a JSON object with model and a random value. This is for indexed storage. And the value. I keep it simple with only one piece of information. That's it. Publish. Live Objects has received the data. Let's go to the right tab. And yep, we have it. We can even look at the details to see the data enrichers work. Good. How can I make the data a bit more realistic? I could use this data block with several data types. And I could add this GPS location from my tracking device. Finally, I could make use of a tag to sort this payload in my business processes. I could add some more fields like stream ID or the timestamp. You can refer to the developer guide for a full description. Let's send that and check the data details. So, here is the data item. In the details here, we can find how my information has been processed by Live Objects. Now, what if my device accepts remote commands? My connector should declare it. Let's come back to the status payload. I add here a capability to my device named command and set it to true. I publish this status. To receive the commands, my connector has to subscribe to a topic named connector slash v1 slash requests slash command. Right, it's registered. On Live Objects, in the device interface, we can see this new possibility. Here. Let's send a command. For example, open the gate number 2. And if not done within a minute, forget about it. And validate. On the connector, we have received the command with the device to which we should forward the order. Let's say that a gate 2 has been opened, so that we send an acknowledgement of the command. This is done via data publish on connector/v1/responses/command with this payload. I set the command ID and the node ID as a referrer. The status and the message can be set as we want to. Let's declare that the gate will close itself. Send the payload. On live objects, we can see that the result status has been updated. We can even check the history and the result here. Further options are available. You can find them all in the developer guide. The URL is given in the video description and is available in the Help Center. You are now ready to develop your first external connector to live objects. And see you for the next episode.
Orange.